Verse 13, and his servants came near and spake unto him and said, My father, if the prophet had bid thee do some great thing, wouldst thou not have done it? How much rather than when he saith to thee, Wash and be clean. Now, if he had told you to do some great thing, you would have attempted it. And how many people today would like to do some great thing for salvation? You don't do a great thing. He did the great thing for us. All we have to do is receive it. We come as beggars. These servants, now they beg him. Then went he down and dipped himself 7 times in Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And I'd give anything in the world if I could have been there and watched that. I think every time he went down, he'd come up and look at himself. He said, this is absurd. I'm not getting clean. I'm not getting rid of my leprosy. And down he goes again. But he went down 7 times, and when he came up, I read now again the last part of verse 14, and his flesh came again like unto the flesh of a little child, and he was clean. And he returned to the man of God, he and all his company. And they came and stood before him, and he said, Behold, now I know that there's no God in all the earth but in Israel. Now therefore, I pray thee, take a blessing of thy servant. And he said, As the Lord liveth, before whom I stand, I'll receive none. And he urged him to take it, but he refused. And Elisha is as difficult to get along with as Elijah is. Naaman said, Shall there not then, I pray thee, be given to thy servant 2 mules burden of earth? For thy servant will henceforth offer neither burnt offering nor sacrifice unto other gods, but unto the Lord. In this thing the Lord pardon thy servant, that when my master goeth into the house of Rimmon to worship there, and he leaneth on my hand, and I bow myself in the house of Rimmon, when I bow down myself in the house of Rimmon, the Lord pardon thy servant in this thing. And he said unto him, Go in peace. So he departed from him a little way. Now, this man Elisha had a servant by the name of Gehazi, and he hated to see that handsome reward slip. And so he took out after Naaman, and he caught up with him, and he said, If you don't mind, why, we'll be glad to take your offering. And when he came to the tower, he took them from his hand, bestowed them in the house, and let the men go, and they departed. He went in and stood before his master, and Elisha said unto him, Whence comest thou, Gehazi? And he said, Thy servant went nowhither. And he said unto him, Went not mine heart with thee? When the man turned again from his chair to meet thee, Is it a time to receive money and to receive garments and olive yards and vineyards and sheep and oxen and men servants and maid servants? The leprosy, therefore, of Naaman shall cleave unto thee and unto thy seed forever. And he went out from his presence a leper as white as snow. Why, greed, may I say to you, another awful sin. The great sin of Naaman was pride. The great sin of Gehazi was greed. Awful sin. My beloved, it's leprosy of the soul.